Good morning and welcome, and thank you for being here. This morning's program centers around the music of Johann Gottfried Walther. He is a contemporary of Bach. Specifically, his dates are 1684 through 1748. Born in Germany, was the teacher to princes in the Thuringian region, and is perhaps most famous for a musical lexicon which he wrote, and also for the composition of 132 choral preludes, of which we will hear several today. The other thing I should tell you about Walther is that he had the misfortune of being the famous J.S. Bach's cousin. And the reason I say that misfortune is because that would be a little bit like being cousin to a rock star. Everyone would know you for your cousin, as opposed to for yourself. And that's kind of what history has done to Walther. It's been said that history is the great judge of worth. History is often an unfair judge of worth, in my opinion. There are a lot of great composers who have been largely forgotten by history. So I've done a lot of work. I've done a lot of work with Walther over the years, because I find his music really, really intriguing in a lot of ways. I'm going to talk a little bit about each section of pieces this morning. That's why I've asked you to be up here, so that I don't have to shout quite so much. Maybe eventually we'll have some kind of system where you can see things from back in the nave, where it sounds a little better. But anyway, hopefully you'll put up with that this morning. So let me go ahead and begin. None of these are really concert pieces. They're all church pieces. And they're all fairly modest. I'd like to begin with the piece that's the title translates roughly to "O God, look down from heaven above." Now, that's a tune. I looked for it in the Hymnal 82. I couldn't find it. I kind of knew it wasn't there anyway, but. It was, however, an immensely popular chorale tune in the 18th century. It's fallen out of use. It's woven into this chorale. You'll probably hear it, but chances are, even if I played it for you intact, you wouldn't necessarily know it. At any rate, it wouldn't be on your top 40 of hymns. The written text begins, "O God, look down from heaven above. Behold, your saints are very few." That was written at a time when the Christian church was in turmoil. It was just after the Reformation. The Counter-Reformation was beginning. But even the fledgling Protestant movement in Northern Europe was finding itself fractured between Swiss Reformation and German Reformation and soon to be English Reformation. Lots of turmoil in the Christian church. As you listen to this piece, I'd like you to listen maybe for some of the sense of longing that Walther tries to convey in this choral prelude. Thank you. not sure where I could find this one other than maybe as part of a Bach cantata. The translation, the title, we should give Christ beautiful praise. That's kind of an amazing title. The idea of beautiful praise. We should give Christ beautiful praise. So two somewhat contrasting movements here, that's it. Beautiful praise, I hope.
Prayer. Thank you.
is perhaps in the spirit of the first piece we heard, a text written at a time when, in many ways, the free course of Scripture was first being re-allowed, quite a phrase. The first line reads, O Lord, how long has your word been obscured? How long has your word been obscured? Again, you'll hear a sense of longing in the first movement, I think. And then, interestingly enough, a sense of surprise in a second movement, almost as if the music is displaying a kind of delight at the rediscovery of the word of the Lord.